Alright, I'm going to test out this, what do you call these sticks? Selfie sticks. And introduce y'all to the very beginnings. Kess, come on, Kess. Come on. Come on, Kess. Kess, these are the founding bitches and sires of Little Trucker Kennels. Kess here is, actually, believe it or not, that's her mother right there. Over in this chair is Dad, and Dad was too big. Didn't really mean for them to get together, but apparently Kess is a slut. And I didn't see it happen. But anyway, this is what came out of it. Now, it's not bad because she's right at the top limit of the size for a show dog. She's going to be about 12 and a half inch girl. Which isn't bad, because that means she's got that length in her. She'll be a good brood bitch. Over here, we have Reba. Reba. Reba Weeba. There's Reba. That is daughter of this one here, which is Athena. Yeah, Athena. And that one over there is Papa. And they have turned out real good. Now, here's her sister from another litter right here. Oh, there's Seven, fixing to fall off. Seven is a black and rust. Now, I'm breeding mostly black and rust, but the reason I've kept these reds is because both parents are black and rust. And little Abner here, he's already a champion. He's got 18 points in the AKC shows. He's going to be Papa to, I know he's going to be Papa to this one, which is, well, he's not going to be Papa, he's going to be, that's going to be his bitch right there. Okay, these two here are already set in stone. Their marriage is arranged. But anyway, we're doing Little Trucker Kennels because these dogs are probably the miniature pincher, not only being called the king of the toys, you could call him the king of the trucking industry, because as far as the perfect dog to be in a truck, you can't get much better than that. I mean, because look at the size and think of a dog that can sleep in your passenger seat. He can curl up without hanging his butt off or his head falling off of your passenger seat. They're good. And all I got to do is say a word, and every one of these will start running into the windows, barking, and everything else. Which in a truck, granted, now they're not going to scare anybody, but then again, you don't have to worry about the DOT officer pulling out his Glock and shooting your pit bull because he was afraid fear of his life. And believe me, a cop can shoot your dog. All they got to do is say they're afraid. Just like they do people. I was afraid. Bang. Your dog's gone. Now, they're going to have a hard time in court saying that this little thing made them a fear of their life. Isn't that right, Savick? Savick, kill. Savick, kill. Who's there? Yeah, you tell him. Even as ferocious as that is, let me get a close-up here. Savick, kill. 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 Kill, Savick. Yeah. You see how ferocious that is. Well, Apollo decided to make himself known. Yep. Anyway. Yes, and you wanted to bark too, huh? You wanted to kill it, didn't you? Didn't you? Kill. Reba. Kill, Reba. Stay. Sit back down. Sit back down. You're on video right now. You don't need to go running and barking. But that was just an example. Okay, where was I? Now, being an ex-truck driver, I know the things you're going to need in your truck. One of them is sitting over there on that couch. You see that? That's a kennel. Every puppy you get from Little Trucker Kennels will come with a kennel. Each dog will come with a microchip there with the Reunite, AKC Reunite, prepaid. I mean, that's one of the things that's prepaid. So all you got to do is log on or fill out the form. That way if your dog does become lost or something, or the collar gets taken off, or for that matter, if somebody else steals them and swears up and down it's their dog, you got that chip in there, and you got the number, you know, there's no doubt whose dog it belongs to. Now, Little Trucker Kennels is also certified with the AKC as a bred with heart breeder. I'm a bred with heart, which means health, education. In other words, I got little plaques that say I know what I'm doing, but I got one from the United States military that I was a veterinary technician, which is basically a food inspector, but he got some animal stuff. I grew up on a farm. I know what a healthy dog is now. All of these dogs are healthy. Like I say, this one here, already a champion. That one there is expectant with, she was bred to a grand champion. And she's got champion bloodlines in her, too. Her daddy was champion. You know, there's no reason. Now, a lot of these show dog breeders, for some reason, they don't want to sell a dog to somebody that's not going to show it. I think everybody has a right to own a show dog. It's like guns. You know, if you want a show dog, you want a dog that is that caliber, you don't have to show it. They make excellent truck dogs. I mean, Apollo's dad, Zeus, he was on America's Trucking Network, you know, with Steve Summers and all like that on WLW at night. So, these are mostly descendants from the famous Little Trucker that rode around the country. So, let's see, what else? Oh, let's go, your kit. You come with your microchip, you come with a box. I even throw in a food bowl that, you know, that you can set in the floor, won't tip over on a bouncy road. Let's see, what else? Come with a tie-out, collar, a training collar, and a leash. But the big thing is, with the reason I got a tie-out for is because, you know, face it, you get your truck worked on, not every shop in the world will let you bring your dog in. So you got that 20-foot tie-out. You can put that out under a tree, or if you can't find a tree, you can get a wet bath towel, wet it down real good, put it over the top of it. It's summertime now. And that'll make a shaded area for the dog to go in. It can run around and poop. And you can go do your business while the dog is secured. You know, these are just things that I wound up buying anyway. So if you get a puppy and you want it to be in the truck, you're going to wind up buying all this stuff anyway. So I'm selling a champion quality dog with a complete everything you need for travel. I mean, this is actually an airline certified thing. So if you have to travel, you know, you have to go out somewhere to pick up a truck, or, you know, like with these multi big companies, you know, you've got a airline certified pet kennel. Comes with the dog. Everything I wish when I started bringing the original Little Trucker with me, I wound up getting it anyway. I wound up getting a kennel, the tie-outs, you know, and I'm even throwing in some puppy pads, because when you get them, they're generally eight weeks old, and an eight-week-old puppy, you know, you might want to teach them to use a pad. You're not going to teach them to use a pee bottle, that's for sure. So, anyway, this is the beginnings of Little Trucker Kennels right here. Hopefully by next year, I'm thinking mid-2019, I'll have enough of them to actually start taking in some customers. I mean, I'll have a couple this year. Probably, I'll probably sell the Reds out of, what do you call it? Savvy. Hey, I'm talking to you. Anyway, I'll sell the Reds out of her. And Athena over there, she may have another litter. I'm thinking right around Christmas. let's see, or a little after, it'll be the first of the year, and I'll sell the males out of her, because I'm keeping the females, because face it, look what they're turning out to be. This is her puppies. This is hers, and this is her puppy right here, which will be identical to this. Now, the only reason I'm keeping these reds is because both parents are black and rust. And the other one buried up under here, that's another one out of Athena and Apollo right there. So she's turning out some really good, healthy, you know, their teeth are all straight. You know, a lot of small dogs, you'll notice that the joints in here are bowed in, comes from a lot of inbreeding. None of these dogs are inbred. Like I say, when you get them, they're registrable. You'll be able to register them, and you'll be able to get a certificate. You'll even be able to get a bloodline. Yeah, I think the basic one goes back 3 generations. You can order a 4-generation bloodline for any of the dogs that I sell. You can hang it up on the wall and say, look, this dog knows its family tree better than I do, than I know mine. So, yeah, these are all, everything, champion bloodline, registrable, microchip, travel kits, everything is going to come with these dogs. And you'll not find a better travel companion as far as size-wise and alertness. Face it, it's a good watchdog, but they're not intimidating enough to be an attack dog. You can train them to do, you can YouTube videos on min pen tricks. They're very trainable, but they're also very alert. So, hey, while you're sleeping in that truck and somebody's out there messing with it, you know, there's your alarm. Or you're out there at the fuel aisle, somebody walks up behind you, you'll be watching. Ain't no stranger gonna come up. Brings a funny story. His daddy right there, a lumper, jumped up on the side of the truck while I had the window partially rolled down. He never got "hey, butt" out of his mouth before that dog latched onto his nose. It's like, you don't jump up on a truck and stick your face in it, buddy. Anyway, they're very alert little dogs, and they can be socialized. They can be good with children and all like that, but they have to be socialized with them. I mean, if you get a 6-week-old puppy and you keep him in the truck and you're the only one around that dog, he's not going to be too social towards strangers. He'll be very possessive. And that could be good, it could be bad, but just know what to expect. So, anyway, I'm at 13 minutes. You've heard me rant about the beginning of Little Trucker Kennels.